John Honnibal. I work for Reach Robotics. I'm one of the embedded systems software engineers. Most days I get involved with programming the robot, writing firmware to go actually in the robot itself. Also get involved sometimes with electronic circuit designs and reviews, and a bit of debugging and figuring out of how the thing is supposed to work and why it doesn't work. To write embedded software, I normally use the integrated development environment for the chip. Now that may be something like MPLAB, it may be Eclipse, it may be the Atmel Studio. My favourite thing I've done for MekaMon, I think really it's programming the add-ons, because they are the smallest parts of the system. Quite a challenge, technical challenge, to get the size of the thing down small enough to actually fit in the add-ons. Favourite tool for what I do, I'd have to say oscilloscope, because it really is the thing that tells me how my circuit works, tells me what's going on. We use logic analyzer as well, but I think the oscilloscope has to be the top tool.
I knew it was going to be oscilloscope.
There you go. Okay, so this is my desk where I do embedded systems programming for the MekaMon. Just going to take you through some of the things we have here. I've got a MekaMon here which is acting simply as a power supply, powering this board, which is doing some tests, and I've got it rigged up on these probes, obviously in times 10 mode, to the oscilloscope. So this is the very fine Regal oscilloscope. We've got some waveforms there from the SPI bus. We've got a couple of power supplies here, which always need to have more power for the various parts of the robot. A couple of gadgets there, and also this one for programming the microcontrollers in the robot. It's something that we often need to have a gadget for programming the microcontrollers. A couple of logic analyzers on the desk here, this one and that one, which is for analyzing the signals that the microprocessors are producing. Laptop, which is the machine that does all the compilations and also gives me access to email and access to the source code control system. This is the IDE. This is actually Eclipse. This is for the chip which I'm programming at the moment. And over here we've got the output from the logic analyzer, which is showing me some signals there which are being picked up from this board. So I can look at the signals on here and do a bit of debugging. I've got the usual data sheets and circuit diagrams and manuals and all that sort of thing lying around. So that's basically the kind of thing I do.
Nice. What about the furry MekaMon legs?
We have furry MekaMon legs, which are standard MekaMon legs, but they've been modified by adding fur. This one is the standard leg, and this one over here is the leg with built-in festoon bulb. We have the very fine Hewlett-Packard reverse
this
Polish calculator.
We want to see.
We have the 3-inch floppy disks. We have the 5¼-inch floppy disks. Of course, got the slide rule so we can do multiplication and division without the need for batteries. Just in case things get really out of hand, we have actually got some punch cards and paper tape. Very important. For listening pleasure whilst programming, I have an 8-track cartridge here. Modern music you might find on compact disc. See, if you need to make some videos, I have here the fine Betamax video cassette. I need to bring in some oscilloscopes, and of course if you need to program the robot, we take the battery out, take the floppy disk and just put that in there, and then we can reprogram it.
Is that actually a fair? I don't know if you're joking or not.
There you go. You're going to have to figure that one out. Okay, there we go. Hope that makes sense. Doesn't make sense to me anyway.
Can you tell me a fun fact about MekaMon? And I have a specific fun fact.
Okay.
It's the moon one.
I can give you a couple of fun facts about MekaMon. When the robot's fully set up, it's not just one computer running around on your living room floor, it's actually about a dozen. the chip which we used in the MekaMon leg, it's a very small embedded systems processor, and it's got roughly the same sort of processing power as the Apollo guidance computer that took the Apollo spacecraft to the moon.
So I can fly to the moon if I take that leg off?
And take a leg, and you have enough processing power with the sufficient interfaces to fly to the moon and back. Yeah, the processor in the MekaMon is actually the same chip as I used in my previous job, which was a traffic light controller. The chip in the MekaMon leg is very similar to a chip I used previously in a CCTV pan and tilt head. I have blown up several MekaMons during development. The processor in the MekaMon leg is about the same sort of processing power as a BBC Micro.
You're going to be a celebrity after this.
All right.
People are going to want episodes just on you.
The main processor in the MekaMon is a fairly powerful microcontroller. It's actually a 32-bit microprocessor, so it's quite a bit more powerful than the processors in the leg, which are only 8-bit. Each add-on in the MekaMon has its own computer in it, its own processor, and its own individual serial number. I think if you're interested in embedded programming, a good starting point is to use something like an Arduino or maybe a Raspberry Pi. But really, the thing with embedded is that you're dealing with electronics at the same time as you're dealing with software, and you're dealing with things happening with a very tight timing schedule. So getting comfortable with using things like oscilloscope, logic analyzer, that kind of thing, as well as being able to do the programming with the programming language. So yeah, you've really got both the electronics and the software to deal with.
Mostly I work with the Adobe suite, so I use a lot of Adobe Photoshop for painting and photo editing. I also use Illustrator for graphical content. I also use a lot of Adobe After Effects for animation and motion graphics, and a little bit of Premiere Pro.